وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. The topic today that I wanted to speak about, so I was asked and I requested this topic, and the topic was keeping the heart alive. That's the title that I wanted to work with. So the first question that we have to ask is, why is it even important to keep the heart alive? What's so important about our heart? The Prophet ﷺ said in a hadith, what's translated as, in the body there's a lump of flesh, and if that lump of flesh is set right, then the entire body is set right. And if that lump of flesh is corrupted, then the entire body is corrupted. And verily it is the heart. It is the qalb. So here the Prophet ﷺ is explaining the importance of the condition of this particular part of us, of ourself, which is our qalb, our heart, the condition of our heart. In another place in the Quran, Ibrahim alayhi salam, in his dua, he's making a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in his dua, he mentions, he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something on the day of judgment, and he describes the day of judgment as يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. That it's the day when nothing will help a person, nothing will avail a person or benefit a person from not wealth, not children, except the person who comes to Allah with a heart that is salim, with a heart that is sound. The question we have to ask then is, what is a heart that is salim? What is qalbun salim? What does it mean? And how do we attain it? Now, in terms of talking about what does it mean? What is a heart that's salim? What does it mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying through the words of Ibrahim alayhi salam that nothing is going to benefit us on the day of judgment except the one, that the only one who's going to be successful on the day of judgment is the one who has this thing, which is a qalb salim. So it's pretty important for us to understand what that is and how to attain it. Now, when we describe a qalb salim, a qalb that is salim, a qalb that is sound, a qalb that is healthy, a heart that is healthy, is one that is free from any defect. Defect here means diseases that take over the heart at times. And basically, the worst disease that can take over a heart is any form of shirk. Shirk here, shirk means literally, it's to associate something with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we know, all of us know what major shirk is, right? This is when we pray to a, you know, worship a statue or make dua to someone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a son or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a partner or an equal. These are huge acts of shirk. And we know, all of us are, you know, Muslim, we all know that this is something that we would never do. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says is the greatest sin. But there are other forms of shirk which are much more subtle. There is shirk in our love, for example. When we love something else as we should only love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's a form of shirk. But it's shirk, it's associating or putting something equal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our hearts. And sometimes we do that. And even Muslims and even believers do that. At times when things are so beloved to us, and here's where it becomes complicated, that a lot of times these things, which we'll say are forms or are objects of attachment, these things are within the halal. That's why they become very, very difficult to notice in ourselves. Because these things are buried within the halal. What do I mean? Well, let me tell you this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, He lists a number of things, one after the other, and says, if these things are more beloved to you than Allah and His Messenger and striving in His cause, then wait for Allah to bring about His decision. So it's like it's almost a very frightening threat. Because you know, if you're talking to a child and you really want to scare that child, what do you say? if you do this and this, you're gonna see, right? You're gonna see what happens. If you give them a consequence, it's like not as scary as you're gonna see, kind of, right? In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, you know, just wait to see until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings about his decision. You know that if you do this, it is there's consequences in this life before the next. So now the question is, what are these things? What are these things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that if you love them more than Allah and His Messenger and striving in His cause, that this will happen? Well, among these things are your children, your spouses, your business, your job, halal job, your homes, the things that your fathers, so your parents. Now, all of these things, there's something in common about all of these things. All of these things are halal. Every single one of these is halal. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us that if we love these things, which are all halal, more than Allah and His Messenger and striving in His cause, that we're going to suffer as a result of that. Now, no one comes and says, you know what, I love my spouse more than Allah, or I love my parents more than Allah. Hopefully, right? No Muslim's going to say that with their tongue. I love my children more than Allah. But we say this with our actions.